masaya kila chama masaya kima alale masaya kila chama masaya kima alale masaya kila chama masaya kima alale masaya kila baba chama masaya kima niya moye babele mansa Tameji like a nimbara I just saw me bojan timma Jame sura in nimbara James
yuku jame Yaya, yaya jame Yaya, jame musa
What a funny name.
What is funny about my name? Is it not the same as other names?
The same as other names?
Yes, of course, the same as other names.
Everyone knows that the name Yaya is for men.
And so?
I wonder how could your father be so naive to name you after a man?
Stop it! Don't include my father in this.
Yaya! Yaya Jame!
Ure!
Yaya Jame!
Yo, Yaya, what are you doing? What have you been doing?
Mom! And the Ogumba son always makes fun of my name whenever he sees me. Mommy said that my name is not a woman's name.
Stop crying.
It's not so, Mom.
Stop crying. Come right in, let me tell you. How your father and I choose to give you this honorable name. Come here. My daughter. You should be very proud of your name. And moreover, your namesake. You don't know how painful it is to be barren. I have been married to your father for 8 good years without a pregnancy. Talk less of a child. Believe me, my daughter. More than 40,000 Gambian dollars in those days has gone into the hands of doctors, marabouts, and even killing, but nothing. I have even been initiated as a Kanyale, but nothing. Your grandmother and father made this house a living hell for me.
Boy, fajj lepp bi mom baxna di li depuis mon ko commencé nan ba légui amatuma ben jamba ndiga buma dan metti o miek lu nek yep werna légui ah way li wutna ci gëna outil dé
assalamu alaykum yaani ma
kum salam men ought to be men but this Ibrahim I call my son is as useless as a toothless hunting dog of course Olof ñay neena kuy ayé hobi ma do ci maye do wabi kuy guma gisi digi mandi du la may gamba du la may laal bit lay ma ben sa bet nit wé
ya ñum man fu bon na ni ñaa ko wara gëna bañ mo mi sédi
hey are you stupid you devil you witch you useless and barren woman all you can do is to open your big mouth why can't you get pregnant or leave this house for men who are ready to have children
Yanyima, if children were to be bought from the market, I wouldn't fill a full container for you.
Fee, don't let me see it.
A single day would not pass in this house without you reminding me that I am barren.
Let me meet you there and tear your mother apart. I'm gonna make sure you come from a girl with a tongue. How many more take a lap? Wow.
Darling.
Yes, dear.
I asked you to give me $500, but still I have not heard anything from you.
Oh my God! You were totally right! I so forgot about it.
Oh.
Okay, instead of $500, I'll make it $1,000.
Oh, thank you so much, darling!
You
I love you!
You're so welcome. I love you too, baby. You are such a big fool! Very stupid and very uncivilized! Can't you knock the door before entering? Huh?
Ibrahima, should I knock the door in my own house? So you don't only go after women, but instead bring them into our own matrimonial house, Ibrahima?
What can you do? What can you do? Fanta, I'm sick and tired of this. I have told you several times. You have a choice. You either bear or you leave.
Oh, you can say that again, darling.
Thank you very much, honey.
Do you know I can take you to the police for this?
Police?
But I will not. But let me tell you something. No matter how long the eye stays, it can never go beyond the sky. Manga kwadef tay. Ele kenen na la kwadef.
Are you done with whatever rubbish you are saying?
And you have the guts to respond?
Of course I have the guts. Let me tell you something. I don't have energy to talk with a barren woman.
Very good, my dear. Very good. Yako teksa boba de.
Gosh!
Yako teksa boba.
What's happening to me?
Sweetheart, since this stupid woman has spoiled our good mood, I suggest we go to some place else so that I can make you happy, my love.
I think that's better, honey.
Okay, grab your bag and let's get out of here.
Where are you from?
I close work since 4 p.m. and yet still I can't have my lunch.
It's not my business. In fact, Lamin, how does that concern me?
Don't annoy me, Aminata. Don't annoy me. How do you expect me to have my lunch then? When you locked up the door at the kitchen, I went away with the keys. Huh? In fact, you still haven't told me where you come from still now.
Well, a man who is just like a baby in bed does not expect much from his wife, does he?
Shut up! Shut up! You useless and immoral woman. If only you know how your name is standing outside. Aminata, then you will try and put some sense in your stupid skull.
I don't care. All I know is that my husband is just like a dead wood in bed.
Konde hanatele. Hanatele, Aminata.
Mantela ham. If you don't want me to go out, you divorce me. Pase ma. Menos ma bad.
Malikum
salam. Malikum
salam.
Fanta, how are you?
Welcome.
No, I am not sitting. I was just passing and I said I should come and say hi to you.
Oh, then let me escort you.
Okay.
How's my friend Ibrahima?
He's fine. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam. Excellent. Kokala?
It's me, Fanta. I am asking for Uncle Dauda.
Okay.
Is he in?
Please sit down, let me call him for you.
Okay.
Dauda! Dauda!
Yes, hello.
Come and answer.
Fanta!
Uncle Dauda.
It's been a while.
Sure.
Well, I don't know.
Can I just be like Uncle Dauda? I came here last week, but nobody was in the house.
Oh, you are right, you are right. I went to Canela to collect my sister-in-law. The lady that you met here now.
Okay. Uncle Dauda.
Yes?
I came here to complain about your nephew, Ibrahima.
What about him?
Uncle Dauda. I can take all the insults and curses from my mother-in-law. But I can no longer bear with what my husband is doing to me.
What has my sister and her son do to you again?
Uncle Dauda, at least if my mother-in-law is insulting me each and every day for my barrenness, Uncle Dauda, that is not much problem to me. But my husband has put all types of humiliation on me.
Huh?
He even bring his girlfriends right into our own bedroom.
What? Is he really crazy? And what did his mother do about it?
Nothing. Nothing, Uncle Dauda. She said if I cannot have children, my husband has all rights to do anything he wants.
Is that so? Anyway, don't worry, okay? Don't worry. Your problems are over now because I have got a doctor for you.
Uncle Dauda, I am tired of going to doctors. Please, all I want and all I am begging for is to call my husband and talk to him. Nothing else.
Fanta. I said by the grace of God, you will have a child.
I am not a stranger to you. You were aware when I was diagnosed diabetic 4 years ago. If only you knew. If only you know how much I spent on my diabetes. It is 10 times more than what you have spent on your infertility.
Our situations are quite different, Uncle Dauda. Diabetes and Uncle Dauda.
Fanta. My children thought the best doctors are found abroad. They decided to airlift me. They took me to the United States of America, United Kingdom, Sweden, and even Russia, but nothing. Fanta, the Wolof of Funsi, Kula Defa Luba, Sokoko Wahule, Bilim Ainonam, Dinana Sibole. Billahi President Jame Moba. He treated me without asking for anything, even a penny.
Uncle Dauda, it's just that I don't have any more hope. Uncle Dauda, my barrenness seems to be growing nowadays.
Fanta, let Gambians not be those fools who sit by the riverbank and yet still wash their faces with saliva. Did I tell you I went to Kanila to collect my sister-in-law?
Yes,
we
did.
She was receiving the president's treatment.
Dauda, Natalie Sheila Menubor.
She is.
I am a clear testimony of President James breakthrough. Sister, if only you see me the first day I was going to the HS treatment. I was married. And after 3 years, my husband died. My husband's relatives accused me of killing him. But only God knows. They sent me out of my husband's own house. My 3-year-old child, who died 3 months later. It was hard for me. My sickness. I had to search for food to eat and a place to lay my head. I've spent everything, from clinic to clinic, marabu to marabu, but nothing. I was so sick that I could not even eat for myself, talk less of getting up from the bed. Everyone abandoned me, except my bed. I was surviving, but not living.
Yeah, she's right. You see, the time I was taking her to join the HS treatment, I didn't even believe that she can make it. I thought that she would die on the way.
But today, who will look at me and think that I've once been an HIV patient?
No, nobody.
All praises goes to President Yahya Jammeh. May HIV AIDS be eradicated out of the Gambia and Africa. Thanks to President Jammeh.
Amen. Moba.
Uncle Dauda, please let us not waste any more time.
Yeah.
Please, sister, tell me how to access this treatment.
Don't worry, it's easy.
And I would also like to go and tell my husband's friend. I know he will be very excited to hear this news.
You mean Lamin?
Yes, Lamin.
Yeah. All right. Listen, let's go.
Boy,
what's
up?
Ajuma yala si rak. Boy, tanga na da boy.
Boy, billahi man, fra yufu la tanga sa.
Billahi.
Aha, boy. Say, why were you not at the Kanila Festival on Monday?
I had some business errands to run. I was very busy.
Business? Boy, you missed. Tell me about it. Boy, if you see culture, especially the way these people dance, boy, they culturize. I just don't understand, boy. And accidentally, when I was returning, I met your ex.
Which ex-girlfriend?
Mariama.
Boy, come on. Please don't put me in that mood. The memories of that girl never keeps me happy. And boy, I used to really feel guilty and ashamed whenever I remember how I humiliated my wife in the past. But the most amazing thing is, boy, I can't believe she's pregnant. And I just don't know how to thank President Jammeh.
Boy. If anyone owes anything to President Jammeh, then it must be I. Ibrahim, you know too well that I've been married and divorced for 3 times.
because I could not fence over as a man.
Okay.
Why President Jammeh cured me and men in my shoe without anyone knowing? Apart from you and Fanta, even my wife doesn't know it's President Jammeh who cured me. She just saw me strong again like a horse when I came from Kanilai.
Huh? Why dega dega sonon?
You can see that out loud,
sonon ga.
Why dega nyaka sonon?
May masi.
Especially Aminata.
Huh?
Boy, she will complain about my situation to whoever that cares to listen.
Boy, like I always hear Dr. Mbow say, the beauty of medicine is to restore health.
Mm-hmm.
What President Jammeh yearns for the Gambia is great.
I tell you.
And may he fulfill it.
Amen.
Mr. President, let the foolish dogs bark. But as for him, his caravan must pass.
Now go home.
To inshallah, I'm very serious. When my wife delivers,
mm-hmm.
be it a boy or a girl, I'm going to name him or her after President Jammeh.
No, listen, you knew exactly that I was about to say that. I don't know of you there. Well, man, when my wife delivers, I must name my child after President Jammeh. What all is fixed?
Double Gende? Bu President Jammeh.
I have a problem.
Me no, right?
So this is how your name came about. My daughter. People are respected by the worth of their virtue, but not by the virtue of their wealth. In this great nation called the Gambia, the smiling coast, he's found a great man who loves culture, tradition, and Africanism, who met his people dying of AIDS, asthma, diabetes, infertility, and give them the remedy without discrimination.
But mom, who is this great man?
This great man called His Excellency Sir Professor Grand Doctor Alhaji Yahya AJJ Jammeh is the man your father and I knew you after.
Do not mock me, I feel like you underrated me, underestimate what I can do. Take me as a fool, stab mocking me. Look, everybody's laughing at me and I don't like it. You don't deny it, cause God created everybody just the way we are. We should be proud of that and stop mocking one another. Cause you are me and I am you. I might be different, Mr. Color, but we are one. Call Rastan, yeah? More loving.